In this video, let's create a loading bar that will go to the next scene only if process reaches 100%. We're going to create a loading scene. Learn how to convert loading script from C# to visual scripting. Or use free macro to do it in 10 seconds only. It works perfect on any platforms, PC, Android or iOS. You can get this project folder free with link under video. Open it with Unity version 2021 or newer. After game is opened, you need to install plugin CineMachine for camera working. In Package Manager, select Unity Registry. Enter name CineMachine. Choose it and click Install. Press Play. The game will work immediately. Use DA to move, space to jump, left shift to run. Or you can use any projects you have. We're going to create a loading scene look like this. First, create a new scene with name, Loading Scene. Double-click to open it. Make sure you add new scene to building settings. Add loading scene first, and then game scene. Open folder you downloaded. You will see this tutorial folder. Import it to our project. This folder will have some background images for loading scene. Let's create an UI image. We will create a background with these JPG images. First, convert them to 2D sprites. Change wrap mode to repeat. Set max size. Then click apply. Let's add background blue to our UI image. I will change its name to top. Set its size to 2000 by 600 pixel. Image type to tiled. The texture has been repeated and look a lot better. Make sure you set scale size of canvas UI. Change it to 1920 by 1080 pixel. Move background blue to half top of the screen. Next, copy background blue and change name to bottom. Add orange to this background. And move it to half bottom of the screen. Create loading bar. Select its shape. And set its size bigger as you want. Copy loading bar background object. Change its name to loading bar color. Then change its color to green. If you change its scale X now, it will be like this. Let's change its origin to left. And try to change scale X again. It works perfect now. If loading process is 100%, scale X will be 1. You can set its default at 0.1 or any numbers you like. Next, I would like to add a text loading. Create a text or text mesh pro UI with name loading text. And a loading number to show how many percent currently. Move it to center of the loading bar. Next, let's create some script to move to next scene. Create an empty object, name event loading. add new visual scripting script. Add event load scene to go to next scene. After loading, let's go to game scene. Add delay time with timer if you want. Press play. Load scene worked, but it made the game scene light incorrect. When you open your game scene, light good, nothing wrong here. To fix the light issue after load scene, go to Window, Lighting. Select Generate Lighting to bake the light. The light setting of game scene was created in this folder. Now go back to loading scene to try it again. All good now. This is folder you downloaded, open it again. Then open Sample Visual Scripting Plus. Copy this event to use it. If you have plugin Visual Scripting Plus, it will be in macro, no macro. This is exactly the same. Copy it. Open our loading script again. Paste the copied event here to replace the old one. All done. It should work now. Enter your scene name you want to load it. Option keep increasing. To keep the process always increase 1% every seconds, whenever it stops counting, in some reasons. Let's print out the process percent to see how it works. Every time process is increased 1%, counted will be triggered. Its value will be 0 to 100%. When you press play, you can see process is counted at 18 and 100. On PC, it runs too fast. On mobile, it will be counted a lot more. Let's make the number and loading bar color that follow process values. First, add them to variables to easier to call them in our script. I'm using Text Mesh Pro UI for loading number. Its value will be process percent number. Color orange is a string, color blue is a float value, so we need to convert a float to string value. To adjust the loading bar color, we're going to change scale x value. Let's use set local scale to do that. We need to change x value only. Scale X will have value from 0 to 1 only, so we need to convert 100% to value 0 to 1. All done. Everything should work well now. Loading bar has been filled and worked well. Because our game too small, and have just a few objects, so it runs too fast on PC. If you runs it on Android or iOS, it will look better like this. We will export it to phones later in this video. If you want to do it in C#, just copy this script. We will convert this script to visual scripting now. Open our loading script. Let's learn how to do in visual scripting. First, create a custom event with name, load next scene. Use load scene async event. Add name game scene to load it. Output is a type of async operation. Add this output to a variable to call it later. In C#, async operation will have value is done and process. But now you cannot find any events from async operation. To get async operation events in our script, we must add it to visual scripting node list. Back to our script. You can see events, async operation now. First, let's use setActiveSceneActivation. If you set it true, right after loading is done, it will go to next scene immediately. But right now, set it false. After loading is completed, it will not move to next scene. Input is an async operation. Next, create a variable isLoading to tell that loading is in process. Whenever isLoading is true, let's update the process values. Get the process values and print out to see how it works. Input will be an async operation variable. Process will have maximum value is 0.9. Let's print it to debug log to see it better. Press play. Process values are 0.2 and 0.9. Maximum value is 0.9. Now let's convert and round process value to 100 to count it easier. Create a variable fill amount for process percent value. If fill amount is 100%, loading is completed. After loading is completed, let's turn off variable isLoading and turn on scene activation to go to next scene. Everything is done now. If you want, you can add a delay time before it went to next scene. You already have process percent number. Now let's add it to loading number and loading bar. Update percent in loading number. Update percent in loading bar. Scale X has value from 0 to 1 only. Now at this event, update loading bar, anytime process updated. You can add it right after fill amount value is updated. All done. Let's press play to see the result. You can see loading percent was updated and showed at 23 and 100. Because our game is too small, so loading runs too fast on PC. It will run smoother on Android or iOS. Enter any names you like here. Version number. Backend, you should choose IL2CPP. And turn on ARM64. Then you must turn on mute other audio sources too. This option to pause and reset the audio when game run in background. After all, create or select your key store. Then enter its password. That's all. It's ready to build and test now. This is what exactly the result on my Android phone. Loading is very smooth and work well. And this is loading scene in one of my published game. There are a lot of objects to load, it will run slower, but very smooth. I added open background to make the transition look better too. You can download all scripts free under video. Thank you for watching.